So, well, hi there. This is now the theoretical summary of the information we achieved from the experiments with our transmitter board. Okay, let's start. So, if you have a transmitter set up, or if you plan to set up a transmitter, you will need to find out a few things. If you want to build an AM transmitter, you need a crystal control transmitter. If you want to build an FM transmitter, you need a VFO transmitter. If you design a transmitter, various capacitors need to get smaller, and the coil needs to get smaller if the frequency gets higher. If the frequency gets lower, the capacitors must get bigger. Also this one here, these need also to get bigger. This is a typical transmitter circuit. If you want to build an AM transmitter, you will need an external biasing resistor. You can modulate your transmitter either on collector, if you add this resistor here, or on base, along with a 10K resistor in series to your audio source, or an emitter. This capacitor needs to be connected if you want to modulate your transmitter on emitter, so the RF flows from here to this capacitor to ground and not through your audio source. Okay, here's the variable capacitor diode. The variable capacitor diode changes its capacitance if there's voltage applied to it, and so you easily can modulate the transmitter FM with this variable capacitor diode. Okay, if you want steel to make a variable frequency oscillator to become an AM transmitter, you will need at least another transistor to get a good signal on higher frequencies. Your buffer transistor can also be your modulator if you add an external biasing resistor, but if you just want to amplify the signal from the oscillator or transmitter, depending on how you switch it, it is enough if you just add a fixed resistor from collector to base. The output then can go to another amplifier, but if the amplifier isn't linear enough, it will erase the modulation. Okay, here's the circuit for a small audio amplifier that you could use on your transmitters. Depending on how big the capacitor is, bigger capacitor, more bass, smaller capacitor, more treble, the sound quality, or better, the sound varies. Okay, in the final amplifier, you have your different types of amplifiers. You can add a resistor or a coil from base to ground to get a Class C amplifier, which has the advantage that it only amplifies if there is an RF signal present, or you can add a resistor from base to collector to get a Class A amplifier, which has the advantage that there is always some current flowing, which makes it easier to design these types of modulators. Collector modulator modulates your collector, as the name says. Emitter modulates the emitter, as the name says. And with the LM386 chip, you can choose whatever you want to modulate, either the emitter or the collector. On the output, you need either to connect a magnetic loop antenna or filter to get from this type of signal to this type of signal. Okay, there are so-called third harmonic crystals. Usually CB radio crystals from the old CB radios are third harmonic crystals. They are oscillating at a third fracture of the frequency that is written on it. So if, example, there would stand 27 MHz on this crystal, it would actually oscillate on 9 MHz. To get only the 27 MHz, we add a resonance circuit that filters out the 9 MHz ground wave and only lets the 27 MHz signal pass. If I do a gate MOSFET, you can easily build a modulator by adding on one gate the RF signal and on the other gate the music. That will give you a modulated carrier on the drain connector. A so-called Colpitz oscillator, which is also known as the oscillator that is mainly or often used in FM spy box transmitters or simply FM transmitters, can be used for shortwave or other frequencies, just depending on the value of this coil and on the value of the feedback capacitor. And you can also connect it with a small coupling capacitor of 2.2 picofarad, depending on the frequency, to your dual gate feed to get a clear AM signal. Okay, you can also add a 100 picofarad capacitor to load the oscillator, which will increase the quality of the AM signal, but also will change the overall frequency of your oscillator. You can also go ahead and take a so-called crystal oscillator and modulate it with a PNP transistor. That will give you a 20 milliwatts transmitter, approximately 20 milliwatts. If you want to set up a transmitter like this, this is a perfect setup for a home, a portable or a homemade transmitter that can be powered in a room. It's not so big. You have two wires, antenna and ground wire, and you have your three RF chokes preventing the power supply and the audio source from getting filled up or just from getting interference from the RF. That is better sound. That sounds better, getting interference from the RF. And that is a good setup for a transmitter. Use three RF chokes. They filter out the radio frequency from your power supply, because as I explained in another video, if the frequency gets higher, the resistance from the coil also gets higher. And that is why you use these RF chokes. Then take your dipole antenna, and with a transmitter like this, built up like this, as a 14 megahertz transmitter, you could get a range of approximately 300 feet, 600 feet, depending on your receiver. Okay, that was my video showing you and explaining you how to design transmitters. You may not eventually not be able to design your own transmitter yet, since you are missing some of the values for all frequencies. But if you're finding some schematics on the internet, I think you should now be able to at least guess or think if this is either a good transmitter or not a good transmitter by the design. I mean, okay, best regards from Stefan.